Welcome back to Beyond Words. On this special feast day, now that Easter has ended, now that Pentecost is past, we have the solemnity of the Most Holy Trinity. And down throughout the centuries, the greatest saints have all pondered this beautiful mystery, the mystery from which all mysteries of our faith flow, the mystery of the Holy Trinity, of Father and Son and Spirit. And prior to Christ's death and resurrection, he does start to open our minds. He starts to let us know what's going to happen when the Holy Spirit is going to come, as he did at Pentecost. And in John 16, in this week's gospel, Jesus gives us these words, that the Spirit of truth is going to lead us to all truth, and the Spirit is going to take what is his and declare it to us. Now, John, in this episode of his gospel, is particularly inspired, very poetic, and a little tricky to understand. You might want to read the gospel on your own several times this week, taking it line by line and nice and slow. But we're reminded of some very simple truths in this, that the Trinity is perfect love, the perfect family, God the Father, the lover, Christ the Son, the beloved, and the love between them, who is the Holy Spirit. That pure love, true love, divine love is selfless, completely other-focused. And when we seek to love one another in our marriages, in our families, in our parishes, in our communities, in this world, regardless of race, background, religion, whatever, when we seek to love, true love is selfless, never selfish. The minute it becomes selfish, it becomes disordered. And when we look at the Trinity, we see perfect, selfless love. But we're also reminded, in this gospel this week, that part of love is truth, that the Spirit of God will lead us to truth. God loves us too much to leave things up in the air, to leave us in the dark, because part of love is truth. And if we don't understand who truth is, and Christ says he's the way, the truth, and the life, we're never going to understand how to truly love. So what are these components that God reminds us of again? Well, if you claim to love someone, you're going to walk in truth. You're going to lead them to truth. If you claim to love someone, you're going to give. It's going to be about what you give, not about what you get, not about what you receive. Total selflessness rooted in truth. And that is a great litmus test. It's a great way to look at all of the relationships in our life, from marriages and families to friendships with coworkers and beyond. Does this relationship lead me closer to God, root me in truth, and does it give more than it seeks to receive? And if it has all those elements, rooted in truth, selfless, self-giving, now we're really living in the image of the Most Holy Trinity. And now we've really achieved something special this week, seeking to become more like God. May God bless you.
More shows can be seen on Faith and Life Television at faithandlifetv.com.